I can't believe you are gone. Oh, I was shocked and sad when I heard the news.
Oh no,
if I should cry me a river, or sob softly within me, oh, I don't know what to do.
Emi omo unba se o.
If I should smile through the tears,
mbona
weep in solitude, oh, I don't know what to do.
Emi omo,
though I know it's better on the other side, and I know it's peaceful in paradise. We are pained, you had to leave us this soon.
All right, thank you. Mm-hmm. Take
it. I love you, love. I love you, my daddy loves
you. Let's go outside, let's go outside. Sir, let's go outside, Tata.
Let's go outside.
Let's go outside. Thank
you.
Thank you. Yes, you are in the room of the bed. Be away, Mary. It will get you. Mary, you pick up for one. I propose to that room. I want to get in this now, boy. Not a boy. Not a lot of my dog. Why are you here? You
Yeah, I didn't do that. I didn't do it. the consolation of your love for them through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Father Adewale Ola Arobo raised him on the then University of the Estado Ibe in the old Oyo State. He started secondary school at Olmert Baptist High School, Oyo State, and had a brief stint at Christ School, Adwe. It is on record that he was among the pioneers of the students who started writing the joint admission and matriculation for JAMB examination for admission into universities in 1978. He then pursued higher education at the prestigious University of Ife, now OAU, and graduated with a law degree in 1982. He was subsequently called to the Nigerian Bar in 1988. He carried out his National Youth Service Corps internship in the law office of E.E. Ajayi Obe and Co. Oyo State. In 1978, he joined services with the Premier Bank, First Bank of Nigeria, PLC, as a legal officer and rose to the position of Deputy Legal Advisor in the bank. In 1992, he obtained an LLM degree from the Faculty of Law of Afemi Awolowo University. In 2021, he victoriously retired from the services of First Bank, having served the bank for a period of 28 years. On retirement, Tani co-founded the law firm of Ijalai and Ijalai with his late father, Emeritus Professor K.J. Ijalai, KJWNDN. He was engaged in active law practice when, in 2002, the former president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari, appointed him as Independent National Electoral Commission President, Electoral Commissioner Rep for Ogun State, where he served until his departure. It is worthy of note that Tani was a well-known personality, a warm-hearted and perfect gentleman, known for his cheerful smile, a father was a beacon of light to all who knew him. He was welcoming, kind, empathetic, and inspired people with passion. He was an advisor to many and impacted many lives positively. Tani was a true son of all, his socialite to the core, and a hard-working man who knew how important it was to enjoy life and take time to relax. He was a member of a popular or religious club. He enjoyed spending time with his family and fostering strong relationships with his loved ones. He enjoyed listening to Christian hymns and highlight music. His favorite artists were Fela Kuti, Kingsley Ade, Ebenezer Obi, and Orlando Owo. Of note, Tani was a member of the Ibadan Recreation Club and also did weekly appeals. He enjoyed swimming, reading, and taking to know with a dear brother. Tani was a man of exemplary faith. He was born into Methodism and practiced Methodism until his passing. His maternal grandparents, Pastor Paul and Madame Libia Jalai, were members of Methodist Church Hall. In 1964, Tani's parents joined the services of the United of the University of Ife, the Ibadan campus, and worshipped at Methodist Church Ibadan in Otedo, Ibadan, until 1966. In January 1967, his parents moved to the university's permanent site as Ife, and they worshipped on the device as Methodist Church in Nigeria, Obalamo, Ife. After his call to Bar in 1983, Tani relocated to Ibadan and became a member of St. Anne's Church in Olete, Ibadan. He married Bonnie in 1988 at All Saints Anglican Church, Yaba, Lagos, and therefore, thereafter continued worshipping at St. Anne's Church with Bonnie. He settled in Methodist Church in Nigeria, Abuja, Ibadan, where his family worships today. In 2021, Tani was appointed Senior Church Steward of Methodist Church in Nigeria, Abuja by Bishop Simeon Oluwole Obaleke, who was the presbyter at the time. He held the position for 6 years, and during his period of service, various landmark infrastructural achievements were commissioned. By virtue of his position as Steward Church Steward, Tani was the church council and was appointed diocesan legal advisor. For over 7 years, he served in the United Missionary College in Olite, Ibadan as the chairman of the board of governors. The college was jointly owned by the Ibadan Diocese of the Methodist and Anglican Churches. Daddy was the former president of NCA Ibadan. Church in Nigeria, Abuja, and held various positions in the church, some of which include former chairman of Wesley Venture, the investment arm of the church. In July 2008, Daddy received the highest award of Methodist Churchmen in Nigeria, ninth of John Wesley, as a testament to the contribution and years of service he had made to the church. Even though his father of losing that, we take solace in the word of God, which says, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die." We thank God for fulfilling and purposeful life, and God grants his eternal soul, for his soul is in ours. Amen.
Please, if you want to clap, let us clap properly. That is a worthy offer of Sanlei Ijalai. God bless you. By the grace of God, a great servant of God, we bring us the word of God in this service, reminding us the need for us to prepare to meet the King who can come at any point in time. Our Father, one time, second, for this church in Nigeria, Father, a moderator of the World Council of Churches, the one who has been in position as a trustee to supervise the affairs of this great church. We have in our midst His Grace, the Most Reverend Michael Penny-Sims. Your grace for us. We envelope in your program. That envelope is for the development of the church. That is the only offering we are going to collect in this service. So there is no need for people to prepare to go to Bethlehem to go and change 500 naira into 100 naira. We are not going to call for any other collection after one. So whatever you have, put it in your envelope once and for all. Side men and ladies, please ensure those who are not having envelope, you give them the envelope. And as we are singing the hymn, item 8, we are going to collect this envelope as we prepare to listen to the word of God. Thank you. Lord. We all are here today because you allowed it. Thank you for being our creator. Thank you for being our maker. Help us always to remember to number our days that we may put our hands, apply our hearts to wisdom from the Lord. Thank you because we know you instruct us now in your words. Because we ask it in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let me first and foremost express our condolences to the widow, of our deceased husband, brother, and friend, Lady Adebola Jalai. God will be there all the time to comfort you. We extend same to the children and my lovely grandchildren and pray that God will also strengthen you and the family, the senior citizens, the junior ones, the in-laws, and all those who make up the Jalai family, and indeed the entire family in all its extendedness. God will be there to uphold each one of you and also to lengthen your days. I send our condolences to all of us, particularly to the executive governor of Ogun State, Prince Dapo Abiodun, and the deputy governor of Ogun State here, Dr. Olaide Adelami, and all those people who are here because of the unique connection that they have had with our dear departed brother, especially those representing the National Chairman of INEC, Professor, and all the other resident electoral commissioners here present from various parts of the Federation of Nigeria. Let me also say that those who are gathered here from over there, the clergy, our fathers, our grandfathers in the Lord, particularly the bishop of this diocese, we are truly, truly united in our grief and also in our solidarity with the family members. And I believe that the Right Reverend Dr. Williams, AO Ekpetakin, will also further express our deepest condolences and our wishes to all of the members of this church, the members of the Omo community, and to all of us who are here present within the community, within the city of Omo. We are indeed need grief stricken, but we are strengthened as well to thank God together for the life that our dear brother imparted. Our son, Olani Olane Babalolai Nalai, indeed. I have wondered in my heart what to say this morning to all of us. I wondered it. And you look at this booklet. If you take the trouble to go through all of the tributes, messages of condolences sent to the family, if you look at them, and if you have been lucky, as I have, to have attended each of the events leading to today, there is something that, you know, there is something that is so rich that you can share. The summary of the contributions of our dear departed brother, I can summarize them into 9 areas. I've taken the trouble to read every tribute, to read every remark that has been made in respect of our dear departed brother. There are in about 9 areas. I've come to know him intimately since 2000. I put out in my tribute to see there. I won't have to repeat it. Since I have to oversee the diocese of Ibadan and the high diocese since December of 2006, and particularly when he became involved in a special way at the Methodist Church, Bodica, in Ibadan, from December of 2010. I know he started work, you know, as senior church steward on the 1st of January 2011. But what have I heard? What have I read the people say about this, our illustrious son, who originated from this city? If you go through, you pick out something, few things. One, he was a philanthropist. Everybody, even yesterday, they said that. I remember the expression of Adia, you know, who was speaking and giving testimony. She was asked to spend 1 minute, but I wish she could have gone on and on. I was fascinated and happy. And see, with what passion this woman was talking. It borders on love. Talks about philanthropies. They talk about donations of his time, donation of his talents. They spoke about his experience and skills that no one can quantify. Go and go through the tributes. And in fact, I was told by the bishops, those who were closest to him, that he understood church administration. Yes, he was a banker, he was a legal man, and so on, but he understood what it is, how it is to administer the church. And I heard also that whatever was good, this man never stopped anything, never opposed anything that would bring progress to the church. I gathered from the writer that he was a cerebral person. The way they talk about cerebral, something that goes on inside the brain. That is, he had that capacity. Not everybody that carries a head has the capacity to be described as somebody cerebral. It was a strategic planner, a vision.
missionary in India. I mean, people spoke about him as humble and very unassuming. You don't know how to talk to my baby. Can't hear that one. If I hear one, oh dear, that is a don't want to bear it. If I can walk in church. If you don't pay, I'm going to buy a new asset. Let's do. Back out to you. Back out to you. You saw. Come on, son. Come to you. You are so sorry. We ask you. Tony. Nígbà tí mo rí ìran tó ṣẹlẹ̀ lẹ́kọ̀ọ́ ní ti Service of Sons and Tributes, báwọn èrò, wọ́n ti pé lọ. Tí mo tún mo di Communication Service láàárọ̀ àná, ẹ̀tún ò bá ṣe tó lóògùn. Kí ni nǹkan tí ó ń gbé wa lọ́kàn láti wá? Nítorí pé ẹni tí a gbé ìlókù ara wọn sílẹ̀ ní lónìí. Nítorí pé onínúure ni olùfẹ́ àwọn èèyàn olùfẹ́ ọlọ́run ẹni tí gbogbo wa ò fẹ́ kó kúrò láyé. If you look at this, there are common expressions inside the tribute. What do I mean? Emotional expressions. Oh, it was a great shock. It was a rude shock. It was unexpected. What would have happened? Is it a dream or a reality that Salim Yalaya has passed on? For me, it was a great shock. Just 6 a.m., I didn't get to know before. You know the social media. I opened to it. I was in the bathroom. And I was about entering. Just saw how something had happened to me. No, I just rushed out and told my wife. She said, it couldn't have been. Ah. Now, and so it was. And so that's why I reminded myself in what one of the hymns of Richard Baxter, who lived in 16,015 to 16,091. He says, Lord, it belongs not to my care whether I die or live. To love and serve thee is my share, and this thy grace must be. If life belong, I will be glad that I may not obey. In short, yet why should I be sad? To swerve to endless day. My knowledge of that life is small. The eye of faith is dim, but it's enough that Christ knows all, and I shall be with him. So we may see our questions in our heart. Why Salawani in Jalari? Why not any other person? Why? Why do young children die of leukemia? And criminals live to be 90. Why? Those things we cannot know. Him like that says, God moves in a mysterious ways. His wonders to perform. He plants his footsteps in the sea and rides upon his tongue. But this is blind unbelief. He's sure to err. If you scan his works in vain, because God is his own interpreter and he will make it plain. Why should we believe in him? Because this world is not enough. That's why I feel so comforted by what I saw of the children, the family of Sam in Canada. When we were singing one of his favorite hymns, you see, and I saw the widow, the wife, singing so passionately. And even the hymn, the standard as he says, look, he will not abandon the widow, you know, the orphan and the fatherless. And I observed she sang it so mercifully. And then she broke down in tears. tears. But I know the words of those youths will forever strengthen her. Because God never abandons you, no matter what. We have to believe in heaven. Because Jesus promised it. Jesus came and said, "Baby, be here." But you have the condition, believe in me. The condition of faith and belief is one of those conditions that you have to fulfill so that you can stay with Jesus in heaven. Jesus promised it. If you are not promised it, it's different. He says, "I go to prepare a place for you." The perfect Son of God never lies, but always keeps his word. I was watching the debate between Donald Trump and Kamala Harris, and everyone analyzing Trump, who says the immigrants are eating dogs and the bats and the pets of the people. No, already. He said, fact check, lies, lies. Jesus is not like Donald Trump. Some of you may like him. That's your business. You can cast your vote whichever way. But Jesus promised us, "I go to prepare a place for you." Our dull minds will never be able to comprehend all that God has in store for us in heaven. But we can wisely and safely leave that in Jesus' hands. He will take care of every detail because it's Jesus that has promised. The Christ who promised heaven was raised from the dead and now lives with us. His spirit is a guarantee of full redemption in heaven. You can fact check 2 Corinthians 1:22. You can go to 2 Corinthians 5 verse 5 and Ephesians 1 verse 13 to 14. What really believing in heaven should do for us? What should believing in heaven do for us as believers? It will cause us to realize that we, as God's children, have the only real security there is. Think of security is there in heaven with Jesus. Real security is not in property, is not in insurance, is not in bank accounts, is not in our retirement income. We are secure in God alone. Thus, like poor Lazarus can rejoice because they know they have life that will never end. Those who believe in Jesus, whether you are comfortable or not comfortable, then you have all the security you want. Whether you can afford to buy fuel at 1,000 or 2,000 a liter, that's not the issue. The issue is that if you believe in Jesus, then you have all the security that you need to have. Because those who die in the Lord are with the Lord. We have one of our favorite things, forever with the Lord. Amen. So let it be. So that's the thing. It should keep us from despairing when we think of our loved ones who are dying in Christ. They are with the Lord now. Their future with God is sure. We need not worry about them. So, family members, let Sahib go in peace. Don't worry about him. His labor is done. That's all. It is us that we have the challenge of living with his God. So, believing helps us to avoid fear of resentment. There are those people who are afraid when they want to go to bed. Will tomorrow? Forget about that. We are safe in Christ. We need not worry about getting cancer or having our lives snatched away in a plane crash. That's not what we should worry about. It should prepare us to be our best you will have blessed one of them. See the beautiful thing about Saigalai, the brief life that God allows you, indeed is best. And we know that that the leading character in the story is victorious in the end. We don't become pissed off when he is getting beat down in the middle of the story. When you are watching movie, the prime character, you know, even when you think that, oh, the end has come, no, you don't get this there. That is the same thing. If we are with Jesus, you know the apostle Paul says, for to me, to live, and I will not go, and I will not go. I hope that is the message that God wants to lay on your hearts today. Believe in Jesus, and heaven is real for you, is real for me, and is real for all who are true disciples of Christ. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
before he decided to also join, he was called to duty to public assignment, service to the people of this country. And the testimony concerning him, even as Ogun Red, you know, he displayed all of the ethos for which the Yorubas are known for. It was not found wanting. I have the pastor in record, was testifying to the father that there was no corruption allegation against him. And we are not in this morning. His Excellency is here. He's going to say more about this. It's a complete gentleman. And even service to his family, he's a family man to the core. He took care of his family. His family takes first position in all the ranking in Paris. And talking about even the church, the Reverend testified of him that he's a good manager of resources, he's a good administrator, even though he's not good to the other ministry. But because of his dedication to duty, he knew that his call to serve humanity. And I will this to the wife, that please, I know this is a time of grief, but please do not grieve. I want you to take something from the father, your husband was a good man, and everybody testified to this. And I pray that the Lord Almighty will keep you, will keep the children, will protect them, and will lead to their full age in Jesus' name. I want to encourage the church to also learn some lessons from this. What is it that is going to be said of us by the time we quit this world? Whether we like it or not, we are going to be. But let's begin to prepare how our destination will be right here in time. Thank you very much.
It is well, it is well with my soul, with my soul.
Thank you.
became the deputy legal advisor of the hospital before leaving on the 30th of June 2011. On February 23, 2022, he was appointed as the resident electoral commissioner of the state by the Independent National Electoral Commission. He assumed office on the 28th of February, and in his role as the Ogun State rep, he played a pivotal part in overseeing several elections across the Northern Delta of Nigeria. He was called the Osun State gubernatorial election in July 2022, the Kogi State gubernatorial election in November 2023, the Central election in Ebonyi State in February 2024, and also led the general elections in Ogun State. Sawari Olale Ijalale was known to be very accessible. He was a simple man. He was known for his humility, his dedication to his work, and his deep sense of responsibility. His kindness and philanthropy earned him very deep and wide respect. He was a loving husband without a doubt of all accounts to his wife, Gola. Was a doting father to his four children and their spouses and his grandchildren. He was God-fearing, he was God-serving, he was God-loving. His Christian faith led to nomination as a knight of the Methodist Church of Nigeria, KPW. This explains why today we have so many bishops and archbishops, both serving and retired, about 12 in number, from across the Southwest, here to be with the family. Without a doubt, Sir Ijalale lived a life of impact. In many respects, his pastor, while he was on active duty to his father, like the governor on those days said, and also like the bishop said in his sermon, well, at times like this, oftentimes we ask questions. We want to ask our father, Baba, how come? Baba, why now? This man was just 65 going to 66. This man was brought up in sadly, in fairly. But we are reminded that our God remains very soon. It is He who knows the end from the beginning. And to Him we shall all surrender. On behalf of my family, the entire people and government of Ogun State, where Sir Ijalale served with us, we condole with the entire Ijalale family, particularly his wife, his children, their spouses, his grandchildren, the entire Sir Ijalale family. We pray for Sir Ijalale, the pool of his soul. We pray that God Almighty accept you and grant you eternal peace. We pray that the Lord Almighty himself becomes your partner, your friend, your companion, the father and grandfather to your children and grandchildren. We extend our blessings to every member of the Ijalale family. We pray that God Almighty grants you enough to bear this very sad and painful loss. The Lord keep and protect us all, and grant all of our companions joining us.
masses back home. Thank you very much for listening, and God bless you.
Thank God for your life, for your in regards to Proverbs 13:31, which says, "He who oppresses the poor insults his neighbor, but whoever is generous is him and not his God." Now, Church, Methodist Church in Nigeria, I was not very proud of your philanthropic ideas. Your zeal in helping the youth in general and the youth of Methodist Church in Nigeria in particular will always remember and appreciate it. You, Sir Barrister Rolani, Methodist Church in Nigeria and the diocese, how will you do? The Lord will remember that the church will get behind you. The proper impertinence you have at this juncture, that your cheerful and general disposition towards humanity, communities, and the church, despite the keeping some of the ethics of the Council of Nights, is a crime in the association's institution. From the little personal foundation, as the party is, before your end eventually pay, it's not difficult to see why we need to buy your demons, which is the part. The part is still hard to live in a perpetually new world. It is rather sad. But no one serves all you need, and therefore, there are toil, care, and heart for every day of eternity. We guide the death of the righteous, we guide the Christ, meaning that we shall partake of the first separation as you reign and endure. And this is where the service starts. Therefore, we, your fellow knights, left behind with our armor to continue the earthly fight, wish you blessful transition to eternity. And good hands, great hands. Once the crown of the dawn of the arisen, glorious resurrection. We can call God. We will now invite the eldest child of the Son of God to please come forward. And in the storm of Father was given the armor, which is this holy Bible. Now it's the time now. But this armor must continue in your home to protect you. So we are handing it over to you. This word of God is not the part of the family, not the part of the life. So, this medallion was also given to him to not be buried with him, because this is the sign of honor that he has been given the honorific award tonight from Wesley. This one will be given to the family and the place of the post in the African cities and will know that the knights passed in this world and in this post. Well, as a token, we are just giving this as a token of our love for God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And I preach that may no premature death in your family in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much.
Heavenly Father, here before you is your daughter, our sister, now the widow of our dear departed grandfather, father, Clary Hoffman. We ask that you look down from above and place your hand upon her head so that she will receive all of the comfort from above. Continually strengthen her. Continually bless her. Hold her by the hand and journey along with her. In the many days and the many years to come, take away from her every form of fear. Remove from her every form of anxiety. Strengthen her, uphold her, bless her continually. And may all that have been said regarding her husband bring joy and everlasting joy to her. Lord, reassure her that you have granted your husband eternal rest. Thank you, Father, because we know you hear our prayers. Let her continually, in days and years to come, cast all her cares upon you and receive the comfort of the presence of the Holy Spirit. We ask all this and many more in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The likes of Mama and Holy Spirit, and God of peace go with you. As she remains here, I want all of us to be outstanding for the benediction. The congregation will all rise for the benediction and at this time.
May the God of peace, who brought again from the dead the great shepherd of Israel, with the blood of the eternal covenant, even our Lord Jesus, make you perfect in every good thing to do his will, working in us and in well pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thank you. And I want
be careful, to please.
Stand behind them.
Fun ìgbàlà wa, àwa fi ìbùkún fún ọ fún ìṣẹ́gun náà
lórí ikú àti isa òkú tí òun ti gbà fún wa àti fún gbogbo àwọn tí ó sinmi nínú rẹ. A sì ń bẹ̀ ọ́ láti pa wá mọ́ nínú ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú gbogbo àwọn tí ń dúró dè ọ́ lé ayé àti pẹ̀lú gbogbo àwọn ẹgbẹ́ ti ọ̀run nípasẹ̀ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa. Bàbá wa, ọ̀rẹ́ wa, arákùnrin Ọláníyì Ọlálẹ́yẹ Babalọlá ọmọ ìjàlàyé, ó fi ìhín sílẹ̀ lọ sí ọ̀dọ̀ Ọlọ́run. Má jẹ́ kí ẹ̀rù kó ba aya rẹ̀, má jẹ́ kí ẹ̀rù kó ba àwọn ọmọ rẹ̀. Nínú gbogbo ìgbésẹ̀ àti iṣẹ́ wọn, a fi wọ́n lé Ọlọ́run lọ́wọ́, Ọlọ́run yóò dúró tì wọ́n. Gbogbo àwọn tí ń sọkún, ìwé mímọ́ ní Ọlọ́run ti ka lára rẹ̀, yóò nu omi jẹ gbogbo nù kúrò ní ojú wọn, kì yóò sí ẹkún mọ́, kì yóò sí ọ̀fọ̀ mọ́. Níhìn-ín la sì ọdé máa lọ ní orúkọ Olúwa tí ó kún fún ọ, Jésù Kristì tí ó rà ọ padà, Jésù Kristì tí ó sì jẹ́ alága rẹ̀. Ǹjẹ́ kí oore ọ̀fẹ́ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa àti ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run àti ìdàpọ̀ ẹ̀mí mímọ́ tí ó máa bá gbogbo wa gbé láé àti títí láé láé. On behalf of His Eminence Dr. Oliver Ali Abba, Prelate, Methodist Church Nigeria, the Secretary of Conference of Methodist Church Nigeria, the Right Reverend Dr. Babatunde Taiwo, the Archbishop of Igbobinne Archdiocese, His Grace, the Most Reverend Olumuyiwa Fafeyiwa, myself, Lord Bishop of our Diocese, Right Reverend Dr. Williams Egbetake, and the entire clergy, we bid you back.
Give it to others. You've done it already. Don't do it.
Quiet.
Please allow them. Relax. Please go ahead.
Right.
Okay.
Gbàgbọ́ lè kọrin nípa ju kí o sì kan. Agbẹ́kẹ̀lé fẹ́ bàbá
wa.
Jésù fún wa lóhun gbogbo.
Iye
tàbí ní
olúkálùkù àti gbọ́ wàásù àti gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ ọlọ́run àti ka bíbélì sí wa létí àti ṣohun gbogbo tán ṣùgbọ́n láìpẹ́ yìí olúkálùkù yóò bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní máa padà lọ sí ibùjókòó tirẹ̀. Àdúrà wa ni wípé kí ọlọ́run olùgbàlà wa agbọ́gbẹ́rìn tí ń wo ọgbẹ́ ọlọ́gbẹ́ kó bá wa wo ọgbẹ́ yìí sàn. It is indeed very painful because this is not what we expected. So it is the sole responsibility of each and every one of us to always keep this family in prayers, to ask God to comfort Lady Ijalaye and the children, the entire large family, and God will do it.
Amen.
Because He knows this. And so, Very Reverend Agbade, can you come forward and lead us in prayer?
Eje ki agbadura. Olorun Olodumare. Olorun to mo wa, Olorun to mo wa. Olorun to mo ibere ati opin wa. Ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ sọ pé nínú ohun gbogbo ká máa dúpẹ́. Ọlọ́run, a rí mọ̀ pé ọ̀kan nínú orí wa kò lè bọ́ sílẹ̀ láì jẹ́ ìmọ̀ sí ìwọ Ọlọ́run. Ọlọ́run, ó yí ọjì wa lọ. Ìdí tí ó fi pe ìránṣẹ́ rẹ, ọmọ rẹ, arákùnrin wa, ọ̀rẹ́ wa sí ọ̀dọ̀ ara rẹ nírú àkókò yìí. Ọlọ́run, nítorí agbára rẹ, nítorí ọgbọ́n ìmọ̀ àti ètò fi ṣe gbogbo ti wọ̀ ọ́ gba ọ̀pẹ wa.
Amen.
Lórí mọ̀mọ́ wa, lórí àwọn ọmọ, pàápàá jùlọ fún àṣeyọrí ìsìn ètò ìsìnkú yìí, Ọlọ́run gba ẹ̀yìn wa.
Amen.
Aláàánú àti olórí ọ̀fẹ́ jùlọ ní gbogbo ọ̀nà tá a bá ti mú ọ bínú nítorí ìṣẹ̀lẹ̀ yìí ni orúkọ Jésù Ọlọ́run dáríjì wa.
Amen.
Ṣàánú fún wa.
Amen.
Bàbá ọmọ àti ẹ̀mí mímọ́, a fi mọ̀mọ́ wa Lady Ijalaye lé ọ lọ́wọ́ àti àwọn ọmọ àti ẹbí lápapọ̀ bá wa tù wọ́n níná.
Amen.
Ọlọ́run nu omijé wọn nù.
Amen.
Ayérayé pa ìbànújẹ́ wọn rẹ́.
Amen.
Ayọ̀ rẹ, Ọlọ́run fi pa ìbànújẹ́ wọn rẹ́.
Amen.
Ayọ̀ rẹ jẹ́ kó máa jẹ agbára wọn.
Amen.
Ikú bàbá wa Abíọ́ fún mọ̀mọ́, fún àwọn ọmọ, fún ẹnìkọ̀ọ̀kan nínú ẹbí lápapọ̀ mọ́jọ jẹ́ àkúfà.
Amen.
Bàbá wa ti ń bẹ Lọ́run nínú ìjọ rẹ kó má jò jẹ́ àkúfà.
Amen.
Àwa ń bẹ Olúwa, ibi tí bàbá ò lè mú àwọn ọmọdé lórúkọ Jésù mú wọn kọjá ibẹ̀.
Amen.
Ikú yìí mọ́ ṣe ní tẹ̀lé ń tẹ̀lé o.
Amen.
Nínú ẹbí yìí dáwọ́ ibi dúró.
Amen.
Ní agbára ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù dáwọ́ ibi dúró.
Amen.
Jẹ́ kí eléyìí jẹ́ òpin irú ìṣẹ̀lẹ̀ báyìí Olúwa.
Amen.
A sì fi àwọn ọmọ àti mọ̀mọ́ lé ọ lọ́wọ́ àti gbogbo ọkàn tí yóò rìnrìn àjò nígbàkúgbà tí wọ́n bá rìnrìn àjò. Ìwàláàyè rẹ jó máa bá wọn lọ.
Amen.
Má jẹ́ kó rí wọ́n sùn nínú àgbàrá ẹ̀jẹ̀.
Amen.
Mú wọn gúnlẹ̀ láyọ̀ àti àlàáfíà.
Amen.
Gbọ́ àdúrà wa.
Amen.
Ọlọ́run di àwọn ọmọ rẹ mú.
Amen.
Di ìjọ rẹ mú.
Amen.
Di ìlú ọ̀wọ̀ mú.
Amen.
Di ìpínlẹ̀ Ondo mú.
Amen.
Di Nàìjíríà mú.
Amen.
Ògo ni fún orúkọ rẹ.
Amen.
Nígbà tí a ó ṣe olúkúlùkù wa náà lọ́wọ́ iṣẹ́, jẹ́ ká dé ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ sinmi.
Amen.
Kí a sì gbọ́ káàbọ̀ ọmọ ọ̀dọ̀ rere bọ́ sínú ayé Olúwa rẹ.
Amen.
Ní orúkọ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa.
Amen. Lord God of heaven, at this junction, this is our experience, and we have expressed it loud and clear that at such a time
You took our father, our husband, our friend, your son. You took him away while we are crying because we did not expect this at this time. And we know you to be a loving God, a caring God. And so, Lord, we don't want unbelievers, because of these incidents, to refuse accepting you as their personal Lord and Savior in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Heal us our pain in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Relieve us of this pain in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
People will be traveling back, and people are now on their way back. Some are traveling now. Grant them journey mercy to their various destinations.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those who will stay behind, be with them.
Amen.
At the end, when the final trumpet shall sound, may we see you.
Amen.
Before we see death.
Amen.
And so may the grace of God the Father,
Amen.
God the Son,
Amen.
God the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
Comfort
Amen.
Each and every one of you,
Amen.
Meet you at the point of your need.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father,
Amen.
God the Son,
Amen.
God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.